Coming up on Pierce County News.
Go, go, go support from the community.
A city celebrates a new levee, a new way to cheer on the Seahawks, and family roots in a local egg business. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. Construction is officially underway on a $16 million levee designed to reduce the risk of floods throughout the Puyallup River Valley. It's the first project to get funding from the new Pierce County Flood Control Zone District, and it's a big milestone for a small city. It took more than 7 years.
This is a day that, at times I thought would never come.
But the little city that just wouldn't give up is celebrating a big accomplishment.
It's not going to just help Orting, the city of Orting. It'll help the cities downstream, Sumner, Puyallup, Fife, and the Port of Tacoma, and all of Pierce County in between.
Breaking ground on the 1.5-mile Calistoga setback levee that officials say will reduce flooding in Orting and further down the Puyallup River.
One of the government's core duties is to protect our communities. The Calistoga levee will protect homes, businesses, schools, and other infrastructure.
The city of Orting got the ball rolling with more than $2 million from city stormwater fees, but it took more than a dozen federal, state, and local partners to make it happen.
Without a collaborative effort with all those agencies and bringing all the communities in, we can't build these projects.
The new 1.5-mile setback levee will be built from the Calistoga Bridge to the High Cedars Golf Club, an area that has seen major floods in recent years. The bank of the river will be pushed back 200 to 500 feet, giving it room to grow and change during flood events, while also creating new habitat for salmon.
New culverts will enable salmon to access 55 acres of wetland and stream habitat that have been inaccessible since the construction of the original levees in the 1930s.
This is the first project to receive funds from the Pierce County Flood Control Zone District, which contributed $8.5 million.
What we can fix and protect up at the top of the river, the head, towards the head of the river, will have a greater impact on everything downriver.
The levee is expected to be done in early 2015. Pierce County will maintain the levee after it's built. The new year has ushered in some changes for local government councils, from new mayors to council members. Here are some leadership appointments you should know about. The city of University Place has three changes in 2014. Denise McCluskey is now mayor. Javier Figueroa is mayor pro tem. And Steve Worthington joins the city council. Puyallup welcomed new council members Julie Dorr and Heather Shadko. John Knutson has been named mayor. In Fife, two new council members were sworn in, Brian Yambi and Winston Marsh. The mayoral vote will take place on January 14th. In Sumner, Dave Enslow retained the position of mayor, while there are two new council members, Earl Stewart and Kathy Hayden. The Pierce County Council leadership will be determined on January 14th. It's not too late for Seahawks and Sounders fans to show off their pride with a special license plate available at the Pierce County Auditor's Office. The Pierce County Auditor's Office opened early on the first day of sales for the new Seahawks and Sounders FC license plates.
We built up that excitement, got a big herd of people in early in the morning, and then we're able to do our regular business the rest of the day.
The plates feature the 12th man flag for the Seahawks and a team scarf for Sounders FC. The cost is $67.75 for a passenger vehicle, which includes a $40 specialty license plate fee. Pierce County sold more than 100 specialty plates on the first day.
It's always fun to add a special touch of customer service and also be able to celebrate with our customers. So whether it's marriage equality, specialty plates, or getting your boat tabs renewed, we try to make every event festive, so it's not just a chore coming in.
Team plates are still available, but there are a limited number. Proceeds will benefit three nonprofit organizations in our state. If you plan to ride the Pierce County Ferry between Steilacoom and Anderson or Ketron Islands, it will now cost you a little bit more. At the start of January, fares went up 3% for all riders except youth. Youth will still pay $3.40. The county says there will be a two-step fare increase this year and next year to help cover higher operational and maintenance expenses. The new 2014 rate for an adult walk-on passenger is $5.15, up 15 cents from last year. Vehicles 21 feet or less will pay $17.30 during non-peak season and $21.65 during the peak season. The five-trip commuter pass has been renamed the Value Pass and is still the best bargain for your buck. For more information, go to piercecountywa.org/ferry. If you receive Social Security, there are some new changes taking effect this year that you should know about. Joining me today is Kirk Larson. He is with the Social Security Administration. Kirk, what are some of the changes happening this year?
Well, the one really big change that I'm sure everybody's going to be happy about is all recipients are getting a 1.5% increase to their benefits. Also, just to let you know some changes with that, what happens is the average Social Security benefit now for nationwide has gone up to about $1,294 for retirees. And if you're on disability, the average disability check is now about $1,148. Also, if you're working and you're under the age of 66 and you're getting Social Security benefits, you can now make $15,480 and get all of your Social Security benefits.
Okay. And I know that we used to always get those Social Security statements in the mail, and now those have been discontinued. Tell me about that.
Yes. For many, many years, we sent a Social Security statement out to everybody just around their birthday. And everybody was used to getting those. However, that was a very expensive option for Social Security. And in these times of tight budgets, we're trying to find ways that we can save money as much as possible. That statement cost us $60 million a year to print and mail out to everybody. So what we've done is we came up with a safe idea, to make sure that people can now get that information right online anytime that they want.
Let's talk about that online capability and My Social Security and all of the things that we can access online now.
Exactly. The best way to get Social Security information is to go to our website at www.socialsecurity.gov. And there you can do a wealth of things, get a wealth of information. You can file for benefits. You can research Social Security regulations and information. And also, we've created something special, and that's called a My Social Security account. That's an individualized account, a portal, that'll allow you to get access to your Social Security information. So that statement that you used to get, that we used to mail out, you can now get that right online by establishing a My Social Security account. Also, if you're already on benefits, if you get one of the My Social Security accounts, you can go ahead and change your address, change your phone number, change your direct deposit, get a benefit verification letter. You can do all of that right online with a My Social Security account.
Sounds convenient. Now, what about the Affordable Care Act? With that taking effect this month, are there any changes that people need to know about?
Yes, very important. A lot of people have said, you know, with the Affordable Care Act coming in, is that going to affect my Medicare coverage? And the quick and simple answer is no. The Affordable Care Act was designed for people that don't have insurance. If you're on Medicare, you have an insurance program. So the Affordable Care Act, for all intents and purposes, really won't affect you if you have Medicare coverage.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you.
Are there stories or topics that you'd like to see covered on Pierce County News? Now's your chance to tell us about it. Pierce County Television has launched a new programming survey on our website. We'd like to know what you think about the station and what you'd like to see more of in the new year. Your comments will influence new programming on PCTV. To participate, just go to piercecountytv.org and click on PCTV Programming Survey. The survey only takes a few minutes, and we appreciate your feedback. Coming up next, we take you behind the scenes at one of the biggest egg producers in the Northwest. We're back in just 60 seconds.
You wouldn't let money just blow out of your house. So when your AC or heater is on, make sure the doors, windows, and fireplace flue are shut tight. If you're headed out, turn down the AC or lower the heat by 10 degrees. And always keep your water heater set at 120. A little bit of common sense goes a long way. Get more great tips at energysaver.gov.
Here's to the things that can keep us safe. Those we use all the time with hardly a thought. Those that are silently standing by to save our lives. And now, those that we carry with us everywhere we go. Many mobile devices will now bring you wireless emergency alerts, real-time information directly from local sources you know and trust. With a unique sound and vibration, you'll be in the know wherever you are.
Eggs are a staple in many families' diets, but how those eggs are created has changed a lot at Wilcox Farms. In our new series, Meet the Farmer, see how the next generation is influencing this family business.
You could say that Andy Wilcox rules the hen house. After all, these ladies do follow him wherever he goes.
Especially the Rhode Island Reds are so friendly. They're almost like a Labrador dog.
And it can be a dirty job, but does he mind it?
Not really. He just got used to it.
The Wilcox farm in Roy is the fourth largest egg producer in the Northwest. It's been a family business since 1909. Now the third and fourth generations are running the operation.
My brother and I had a requirement for any of the fourth generation to come back and work on the farm or to be a part of the management. They had to graduate from a four-year college and had to work someplace else for 3 years.
It was the fourth generation that forecast a change in what consumers wanted, influencing Wilcox to shift into cage-free and organic egg products.
When the fourth generation came back, they could see that being just getting bigger and bigger and bigger wasn't what they wanted to do.
35% of Wilcox customers buy organic. The Seattle-Portland region is the second in the nation behind the Bay Area in demand for organic products.
We have 500 acres of organic cropland that we're growing small grains that we actually are feeding to our chickens in the feed ration.
With 1.2 million chickens in three states, Wilcox is producing 80,000 dozen eggs a day. Costco is their biggest customer. These eggs were laid today. They'll be washed and inspected, then they're packaged and prepared for delivery. A half million eggs will reach customers tomorrow.
One of the things that we've gone to in the last year are these peeled eggs because consumers want convenience.
Wilcox has a goal to be 100% cage-free and organic within a decade. And you can bet it will be a family effort.
I work with my dad, and not only my dad, but my cousin and my brother. So it's like a family reunion every day.
Dave Hinman, Pierce County News.
What's fresh now and available year-round? Eggs and some poultry products. To find your nearest source for farm fresh eggs, visit the Pierce County Farm website at piercecountywa.org/farming. Up next, it's an event for daddies and daughters. But first, here's some dates for your calendar. If you're still looking for a place to get rid of your old Christmas tree, why not tree-cycle it? Pierce County residents who pay for yard waste collection can put their unflocked tree right in their yard waste container. You'll need to cut it into smaller pieces to be sure it fits in the closed container. All trees collected will be composted into prep compost, a soil that is popular with gardeners, or drop the tree off for free at a Pierce County transfer station. For more information, go to piercecountywa.org/treecycle. If getting a new job is your New Year's resolution, head to the Puyallup Library to learn how to sell yourself and your skills in today's job market. Advertising your abilities is just one of the career workshops offered at the library. It's happening on January 15th from 1:30 to 4:30. To register, go to puyalluplibrary.org. This week, Mark Richards is getting ready to test his dance moves. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Heather. It's time to dress to impress for this year's Daddy-Daughter Dance. Get ready for the 2014 Daddy-Daughter Dance, held at Frontier Park in Graham and Sprinker Recreation Center in Spanaway. These events are held on two different weekends for dads and their daughters. This will be a festive evening filled with dancing, pictures, and refreshments. You must pre-register for this event, and space is limited, so please sign up early. Don't let the cold weather slow you down this winter. Sign your child up for indoor soccer held at the Lakewood Community Center. There are leagues for boys and girls ages 4 to 7. The $45 fee gets you a t-shirt, players clinic, and at least 7 games. Registration is happening, so for more information, call or go online. So dads, it's time to hop on YouTube and brush up on all the latest dance moves. Well, almost all of them. Back to you, Heather.
Whoa. Look at those moves. Thanks, Mark. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. For more local focus, watch your city council meetings and see what's happening in the new year. You can catch all of the council meetings gavel to gavel on our website at piercecountytv.org. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.